Hello children, how are you all? I'm sure you're watching all the videos and learning from them. Children, we have finished two chapters in science. So, we thought of giving you a revision of these. Watch these videos carefully.
Revision of Lesson 1. Matter. States of matter. Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. Matter exists in three states: solid, liquid, and gas. The arrangement of particles differ for solid, liquid, and gas. Solids. The particles in a solid are very closely packed, have a fixed shape, and are hard to touch. For example, books, pen, pencil, table, and chair. Liquids. The particles in a liquid are not packed very closely. Liquids do not have a fixed shape, can easily flow and take the shape of the container. Example, water, milk, juice, etc. Gases. The particles in a gas are very loosely packed. Gases do not have a fixed shape. Example, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor. Changing states of matter. Matter can change its form from one state to another, either by heating or cooling. Water exists in all the three states: solid, ice, liquid, water, gas, water vapor. Melting. The process by which a solid changes into a liquid is called melting. Ice, which is in solid form, melts to water, that is liquid, when it is kept outside the freezer. Freezing. The process by which a liquid changes into solid is called freezing. Now, when a liquid is cooled, it changes into a solid. So, when we keep the water back into the freezer, it will become ice, that is solid. Boiling. The process by which liquid changes into gas on heating is called boiling. When water, which is in liquid form, is heated enough, it changes into water vapor, that is gas. Condensation. The process by which gas changes into liquid on cooling is called condensation. Now, when steam, that is in gas form, touches the cool surface of the lid, now which has got ice cubes on it, it changes into water, that is liquid form. Now, this process is called condensation. Water cycle. The continuous cyclical process in nature by which water changes from one state to another is called water cycle. Now, you can see in this picture, the sun heats up water present in oceans, lakes and rivers. And this water turns into water vapor. This process is called evaporation. Similarly, plants and trees, they also lose water in the form of water vapor. That is called transpiration. Now, as the water vapor rises up in the air, it starts cooling and form tiny water droplets. Now, these water droplets come together and form clouds. This process is called condensation. Now, when clouds get heavy enough and cannot hold the water droplets, they fall back to the earth in the form of rain, hail or snow. This is called precipitation. And again, this water which has fallen back on the earth is collected in the form of lakes, rivers and oceans. Children, with this we come to the end of our chapter 1 for revision. I am sure everything is clear to you. Keep learning and keep watching all the videos.